views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio. Welcome to the Angels and Answers Psychic Radio Show with clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegel. Artie is renowned psychic medium, spiritual life coach, and entertaining motivational speaker. Sky's given talent of inner guidance gives her the ability to interpret feelings and images impressed upon her by the spirit world. Call now for answers from your guardian angels and loved ones at 800-930-2819. And now here are your hosts, Artie and Sky.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to another week of Angels and Answers with Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegel. How are you guys?
You got it, baby. That's us.
Yeah. I'm holding a piece of beautiful pink quartz in my hand. And the reason for that is I want to invoke all of my beautiful angels to me. And when I hold this pink quartz, my hands vibrate. Even right this moment, my hands are tingling. And it's not because I'm rubbing it on my hands. It's because I have invoked all my angels to come to me today and to be with me and to make me acknowledge and understand and know that they're here. So they're giving me right this moment a beautiful message that don't worry, Sky, I'm here. I'm here with you. And anything you want and everything that you need, just ask. And, you know, that's a really good thing for you guys to do, too, because we're all born with a guardian angel. And not only are we born with a guardian angel, but we have a whole team of angels with us. And when you call them, they will help you for everything and anything. Nothing is too stupid. Nothing is too small. Nothing is too large. Call them in and help. Get their help. They're standing there waiting around. They're not going to come to you and say, oh, we're going to intervene. They're not going to do that. But if you call them, they will come to you. They'll be at your service in less than a nanosecond. That's what I've learned.
Well, I've been like that since forever.
I know, but I have too. But I want to share that.
No, that's good. Why do you feel like, you know, being that the angels are always there, like when you need answers, whether it be personal life or whether it be for your readings, you know, I always feel that they're always there. It's like, and I'm not worried, you know, like when crap hits the fan that, you know, oh, angels, I need you. They know that you're in deep poo-poo about whatever it is. So literally, I just calmly say, you know, please intervene and take care of this mess.
Well, that's the key. You're calling them.
Right.
You see, if I'm in deep poo-poo and I forget to call them, they're just going to stand around and just grimace at me. What's wrong with you, girl? Don't you know it's by now? Mm. So what I do is when I am in deep poo-poo, I do call them in. And they never, ever fail me. Ever.
So what I say to the angels, I said, I want you to assume you're me. And then as soon as you see me in deep poo-poo, I just want you to take over and make things right. Don't make me have to repeat myself. I'm telling you once and once only. If I told you once, I told you 1,000 times.
You know, I got a message from my angel one time, and honestly, in a dream, and it was the day that I was yelling at one of my angels, and I was yelling at him, and I was saying, what the heck is the matter with you? Didn't you see what was going to come? Why the hell didn't you tell me what was coming? I got really annoyed.
You know, after we do readings, you know, whether it be you, me, even, you know, to say for myself, I'll speak from my own personal experience, and I'll do a reading for people, whatever. And like the next day, something will happen. They'll get in a car accident or just something inconvenient happens to them. And they go, Artie, why didn't you tell me? It's like, well, obviously you were meant to go through it.
That's right.
You know, unless if whatchamacallit, you know, that, hold on a second. Unless if, you know, I just lost total
time. I know you did.
You're with your hand signals.
I know. I made hand signals.
Yeah, I'm putting in my order for hot tea with lemon.
I told you, see what I did?
Oh, okay, yeah.
So I said, no milk. Oh, there, yeah.
Then you shouldn't have been squeezing them.
I know. What he's trying to say is we're not supposed to know
certain
things.
Yeah, we're not supposed to know everything.
We have to go through things on our own in life.
And not just for us, but even for when we do readings for people. So if we leave a party or a private session and all of a sudden deep crap hits the fan, then you're meant to go through that.
Yes.
And people automatically assume, like, one of my pet peeves is – you'll ask, oh, so what's your name? Oh, well, you should know that. Or I'll say, where do you live?
Hate that.
Yeah, where do you live? What do you do? Because sometimes, when you want to help somebody with their career, you can't always just get the answer what their career is. And I say, I don't see what what you do for a living. And they'll go, well, you should know that. Well, you should know that. And
no.
I hate when people say you should know
so
that.
So do I.
Because we don't know everything based on our own recognizance. We know what we know based on the angels expressing that to us.
Right.
And if any of you want a reading from Sky and I, during this 2-hour segment, feel free to give us a call at 800-930-2819. 800-930-2819. If you want a private reading or if you want to add to the conversation or put in your 2 cents.
Yes,
and
we'd love to have
yada, yada, yada. Yeah. So
what Artie's saying is absolutely true. Sometimes we'll give a reading, and a couple of days later, I'll get a call. Sky, why didn't you tell me my dog was going to die? Well, I'll tell you why. Because the angels and our Holy Spirit needed you not to be prepared for that, to see how you handle those situations in your growth process. And everything that's negative that happens to us that we don't know about or know that's coming is a growth process. We're growing from that. We learn how to handle it. We learn lessons from it. And it's very important, those growth processes.
And sometimes by you knowing certain things in advance, you're going to get in the way of a natural process of what's meant to be.
That's right.
And so you can't stop and save everything. So that's why I tell a lot of people, there's a lot of people out there, I mean a lot of people out there, who carry a lot of guilt about a loved one's crossing because they say, oh, what should I have done? I could have done this. I didn't do this. I didn't do that. I wish I did this. And you want to know something? If you knew everything in advance, that's like getting mad at yourself for not knowing the lottery so that you could, live a very financial, comfortable life. And, there are certain things that are just meant to be just the way it is. And, so even though you were right there or you didn't make it to the very end when they passed, or you could have done something. And there are people who, our loved ones who have committed suicide, and I can't believe, I feel so bad, I could have done. No, because they were blocking you from knowing this. The people who did it, they purposely blocked you so that, you wouldn't, do whatever, change your thoughts, change your ways or whatever. They didn't want you to intervene into their life. The people who say that they're committing suicide or I'm going to kill myself, they really don't want to kill themselves because they're reaching out for help that way.
That's a cry.
That's a cry for help, not like, if you're going to do it, you're just going to do it without telling anybody. And unfortunately, the people who are successful at it knew not to tell anybody because they just didn't want to be blocked. Now, unfortunately, that's their bad circumstances that they have to go through that process. It's not until after they do the bad deed that they realize that they made a mistake. But when you're in an emotional, really bad state of mind, you can't save somebody who doesn't want to save themselves, And so, that's a sin for you to try to think or to beat yourself up saying, I wish I knew. Yeah, of course you wish you knew, but I wish I could have done something.
Sometimes you just can't do it because that's their contract. That's what they came to do.
What?
And I know it sounds crazy. Let's say somebody commits suicide, right? Before they were born, before they were reincarnated, they signed a contract.
I don't know, but I don't believe. I believe, from what I was understood, that all deaths, with the exception of suicide, is not within the contract.
I'm going to tell you something.
I don't. That's something where Sky and I might disagree because I don't believe that suicide is a part of a natural process. I feel that you have a knowingness that your depression or your feelings might lead up to this, but I feel like we're not supposed to.
Oh, I do too, but
commit suicide because you have an agreement to fulfill to go through all your responsibilities of what you've created up to that point, up to that date, and it's time for us to take responsibilities and to go through the process.
Yes.
You know, committing suicide, because you're going to be reliving the life all over again.
But
so.
Wait a minute. What you're forgetting is this very important fact, that if you sign an agreement for a suicide, do you know whether or not you're signing that agreement for someone in your family to grow? Just think about it. Yes, suicide is terrible. You're not supposed to commit suicide. However, there are many people who do that. Regardless of help, regardless of medication, regardless of everything, they have just had it. It's their exit point, and they do it. Now, how do you know that the contract that you signed in heaven before you came down was to make suicide, make yourself kill yourself, because the person who you're living with, or your mother and father, or your siblings needed to learn a lesson from that?
I feel like it was the lesson learned as far as dealing with the depression, not necessarily the suicide, because you don't have control. This is a possibility of a suicide, you knowing this before you're born. But as far as the actual suicide, you don't have control of that.
Yeah.
But Sky and I, we got to go to a break right now, so
yes,
we'll discuss more of this.
Dear ones, come back.
That's right. Stick around, because Sky and I, we're going to be right back right after this commercial break.
Ta-da.
For a juvenile, but then if you're so smart, tell me, why are you still so afraid?
My dream is to end homelessness.
My passion is living a green life.
My dream is to end poverty.
My passion is volunteering.
My passion is making a difference.
My dream is to cure Lyme disease.
My passion is rebuilding communities.
My passion is helping those in need.
My passion is caring for the elderly.
My dream is to find a cure for cancer.
My dream is to leave a better world for my children.
We all have that special passion, that lifelong dream that drives us to live our lives with meaning and to create a better world. No matter what drives you, we can all make an impact. Dr. Pat Basile is helping others make their dreams come true, so we can all help make our world a better world.
To learn more about how Dr. Pat is building a community of sharing hope, strength, funds, knowledge, and information, visit abetterworldcrowdfunding.com today. That's abetterworldcrowdfunding.com.
Tune in to the hit show Master's Chambers with your trusted friend, Connie Fife, Mondays, 1 p.m. Pacific, 4 p.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. Each week, Connie will connect you with the best of the best thought leaders from around the globe to share their strategies and best practices. Getting better together. To book Connie, visit ConnieFifeSpeaks.com.
We Carry the Light with host Dr. Susan Allison is the show that inspires you to find the light within and shine your light in the world. You'll hear from guests who model how to be the highest, brightest, most evolved, fulfilled, and conscious humans possible. Tune in each Thursday, 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com and let Dr. Susan help you discover that you carry the unique light that only you can shine.
Artie Hoffman is the hottest psychic with the warmest heart and the host of the hit show Angels and Answers. A renowned psychic, medium, spiritual life coach, and an entertaining motivational speaker, Artie has helped over 15,000 people with his amazing intuitive gifts, his passion, and his humor. Call 877-ANGEL-02 to schedule a personal reading or to have your own psychic Artie party. That's 877-ANGEL-02. And visit ArtieHoffman.com and Angels and Answers on Facebook.
called the Oprah of radio by her listeners. Award-winning host Dr. Pat Basile is blowing the doors off of traditional talk radio. Get ready for an energizing delivery and powerful interviews with leaders in the field of human potential. Dr. Pat's fresh, new perspective on living life full out has catapulted her show to the top of talk radio. Tune in and Dr. Pat will help you thrive instead of merely survive. Visit thedrpatshow.com. That's thedrpatshow.com for listening times in your area.
Sky Siegel co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
Shark, babe, has such teeth, dear, and it shows.
Hello, everybody. You're with Artie and Sky with Angels and Answers. As always, it's a pleasure for us to be here with you and talk about life and talk about angels and talk about everyday stuff
that everybody goes through.
We try to be down to earth.
Yes.
And so that everyone can relate to what we're talking about. And
yes.
And we believe that we're helping out a lot of people. That's our purpose of doing this show, to help out a lot of people so that they could relate to what we're saying.
Correct.
And to help them overcome things. And when situations or feelings are put into words, it really clears a lot of your thought process. So hopefully that will give you back your power and give you understanding so that you could overcome your obstacles.
And to know that you are not the only one that's going through exactly what somebody else is going through. We are all the same.
Right. And that's why Sky and I, this is our blessing, to help give you answers, to help you overcome your grief or your circumstances, or to celebrate. You know, it's right. Not just all bad stuff.
Right.
We do have some good stuff in our bag.
Yes, we do.
We're not filled with just black hole in our bag.
No, we're filled with such good stuff.
Yeah, we are.
We got good stuff, baby. Yeah, baby. We keep our energy high and our pockets full.
I was just say our pockets. Our energy high and our pockets low.
No.
Pockets are high.
We have to manifest this in order for it to actually be true.
That's right.
So your words are very important. Yes.
Your words are very important.
Very important. That's why I didn't say empty pockets. I said full pockets.
Full pockets. That's what I'm talking about. All right. Here we go. We got somebody on the line.
Yes. We have Debbie from Georgia. Hi, Debbie.
Hi.
Deb, you got to talk into the microphone of your telephone
okay. And
turn off your radio because we cannot hear you, love.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Oh, great. I got some good news.
Tell us the good news.
You're pregnant.
With you. We just got approved to be foster parents for my second cousin that's 17 years old.
Wonderful news. That wasn't that far off.
We have really gone through a lot of hell through the defect stuff, trying to get approved. It's taken 7 months. And we will have her on Friday from North Carolina.
Oh, how beautiful. Congratulations. That is such a blessing, not only for you, but for her. And you have to know that your angels are applauding you right now. That's beautiful, honey. That's
beautiful.
We thought
we were going through hell just a little bit, just kind of to really fight for her. My goodness.
It's such an amazing feat that you didn't quit. Never quit.
No. Never. But you were talking earlier about people trying to do suicide, and she actually attempted this back in August when she had no hope.
Oh,
and I asked her about her hope, and she said she couldn't really talk about it. She got really choked up. Oh. She said, me and my husband have given that to her. How about that?
Well, I just want you to know that, you know, even though she's in your possession and things are looking, you know, much better and stuff, I still feel like you're dealing with a child who still has emotional issues.
Yes.
That you're going to be dealing with, and you're going to definitely be challenged, and you need to like just nurture her. I feel like it's very important that you inspire her, give her that nurturing attention, like let her know how great she is. Is there anything she'd like to do or what she wants to do? And just, you know, it's like everything she does, you got to make it like it's a big deal. And that's fantastic, because in her world it is. And if you get excited, she'll get excited, because enthusiasm is very contagious.
And a lot of love, 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 love. Even if you're not the type of family that shows their love in a demonstrative way, meaning that you literally go over, hug and kiss, try to do that.
And just because she's in a very vulnerable position, and you feel sorry for her, whatnot, it's very important that you stand true to your integrity and you don't let her manipulate you because of her, you know, the way what happened and her unfortunate situation.
Yes.
And so long as you show her tough love and like just really let her know that you're in her corner, but you can't allow her to get away with any, you know, with everything.
Right.
You know, I'm not saying to be a Gestapo, but at the same token, I'm not saying to be a mush-mush. And if you feel like you're being challenged with her, say, okay, well, what's a win-win situation? You know, if you create a compromise and a win-win situation with her, I really feel like that's going to be your best avenue to help balance the energy with you guys. But you could definitely expect some manipulation and some challenges, you know, having her as your daughter, which we're very excited about for you.
So. Very excited. And you know what, too, Debbie?
Yes.
Touch is healing. So when I tell you touch is healing, even if you brush her hair, I'm sure she's not used to any of this, you touch her cheek, hug her, kiss her. That's so healing.
And a lot of people love their hands or feet massage.
Yeah.
You know, while you're watching TV or just to chill out.
Yes.
And just try to read her in the sense of, you know, when she doesn't want to be touched or if she just wants her little space here or there. Don't keep on asking her, is there anything wrong? Is there anything wrong? Is there anything wrong? Because that's going to push her away. So you have to try to also respect her privacy and let her share on, you know, whatever it is she wants to share, but always to let her know that you're always there to listen if she has any problems or any obstacles. And when you're asking for the truth from her, if it's something that is not pleasant to you, you can't beat her up emotionally. You need to like try to explain things to her in a proper way, because, you know, anybody who is strong enough or trusting enough to tell you their truth, even though it's not what you want to hear, you'd be hurting her if you jumped down her throat when she's trying to be open and honest. And now she feels like, I can't trust you. I can't share everything and anything with you.
Right.
So if you want to be the kind of parent where she's going to, and you want her to share anything and everything where, you know, it's on safe ground, then you have to learn to be a very good listener and, you know, and also know when it's okay to help solve maybe some of her problems, but not all of her problems, because not everybody wants all their problems to be solved. They just need to vent.
Yes. Right. It's very important what Audie just said, to be able to let her feel comfortable enough to come to you with the good and the bad.
And this is where you need to be unconditional and very try to be understanding. And, you know, but the most important is that she respects you and your husband, and she respects the grounds where she where you live, you know, as far as whether it be, you know, within your home or within her room, and say, listen, you know, you need to keep up with yourself. You need to stay on top of her and just not let her just do with whatever. And say, you know, everything is a compromise. Everything's a balance.
Right. You know, it's
I would
difficult.
Like to ask about, she told us that she was atheist.
And that's fine.
I want to know, right, and we told her it was fine. And I was going to ask, I know God always brings you to him in a way. And I was just wondering what way it would be for her.
You know something? I think that this is going to turn around. I don't feel that she's going to be an atheist, because I feel that you are going to project the blessing of God bringing her to you. Not only her bringing, not only God bringing you to her, but her to you. And when you speak of God in the home, it's always going to be in a positive fashion. And it's always going to be related to something good that happened. So I think she's going to realize after a while that, you know, I think she thinks right now, because so many bad things have happened to her. She's not living with her mother. She's gone through hell and back. She doesn't believe in anything right now. And it's very normal. But I know that you're going to change it around. Don't push it. Just subtly bring it through.
It's her anger that is saying that there is no God.
Right.
And God understands this. And God could say, all right, now I know you're angry at me or the world, and I know you're upset or you're fearful. I get it. I mean, I'm still God, but, you know, I get it why you don't believe. But don't worry, things will turn around. And, you know, but there will be a course of events that will – she will be blessed with that will help her open up her heart. But that's going to do a mind job on her, because she's trying, her ego is saying there is no God, but then her spirit's going to experience there is a God.
Yes.
So she's going to go through this transitional weird situation. But it's very important that if you disagree with what she's saying and say, huh, that's interesting, why did you come to that conclusion? And whatever her answer is, and say, okay, I understand what you're saying. You don't have to challenge her. But you can maybe express maybe some of your personal experiences, but never deny her truth or her true feelings.
You're better off. Excuse me?
What? What were you saying?
I asked her why, and she said she can't believe something she can't see. And I said, what about love? What about, you know, but you get that. She says, well, you show me love. I see love. But she can't believe something she can't see, is what she told me. I'm like, okay.
There's going to come a time when she's going to have a miracle happen to her. And I'm guaranteeing you that she's going to be more spiritual than anybody that you've ever run across. But don't throw a organized religion in her face. Got to be the worst thing you could do.
Oh, no.
Her experience, her own experience. But right now we got to go to a break, and it was a great pleasure to talk with
you.
And we're very excited for
you. Yes, thank you, Debbie. Good luck. God bless you.
All right, everybody, stick around, because Sky and I, we're going to be right back right after this commercial break.
To the Angels and Answers Psychic Radio Show with clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegel every Thursday for a two-hour show, 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio. Artie and Sky deliver spiritual and motivational messages with passion and a sense of humor. Call in 800-930-2819 for live and on-air readings. Visit ArtieHoffman.com and SkyOfAngels.com. Tune in each Wednesday at 1 p.m. Pacific Time, 4 Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio to Limelight Radio with Katina Macris. This is an inspirational, cutting-edge radio show educating worldwide listeners on a diversity of Lyme disease-related topics. Each week, Katina will interview some of the world's leaders in health, wellness, spirituality, and human potential. For more information, visit LimelightRadio.com.
Tune in to Prescience Life Radio with host Mia Simone. Mia is devoted to sharing her extensive knowledge on the invisible worlds of energy. Join Mia and discover the science of intuition and connect with your greatest gift. Start living in your potential today and every day by opening up to the power of inner knowledge. To learn more about Mia, visit PrescienceLife.com.
Pure and
Encapsulations is committed to producing the most complete line of research-based nutritional supplements, from fish oil to probiotics to multivitamins and more. Available through qualified health professionals and community pharmacists, finished products are pure and hypoallergenic to optimize the long-term health of all patients, even the most sensitive. With Pure Encapsulations, you can rest assured that you're getting the purest and highest quality nutritional supplements available. Ask a qualified healthcare practitioner about Pure Encapsulations today and discover why it's the supplement brand of choice for healthcare professionals worldwide. For more information, please visit www.pureencapsulations.com. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. These products are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Siegel, co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman, as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
Do you want the freedom to spend more time with your loved ones? Travel the world? Live spontaneously? Get ready, because the Chip Justice Show is here. Hosts Dr. Pat Basile and Chip Justice can help you build meaningful success while embracing life. Living a life you love is the end game in this new, inspirational, and empowering show. Positive changes for a life you'll love. Tune in every month on TransformationTalkRadio.com and visit PositiveChangeInstitute.co for more information.
All right, welcome back, everybody, with Artie and Sky, Angels and Answers. I want to say, hopefully, Debbie, that you're still listening from Georgia, you know, because you were saying, and this goes for a lot of people, and I wrote this beautiful piece, which is going to be in my book. And for those of you, you know, that's a really good question. I have a hard time believing in someone or something that I can't see. And the piece that I wrote was like, God is like the sunshine on a cloudy day. Just because it's a cloudy day doesn't mean that the sun is not there shining. It's just that it's covered up by anger and by your fear. And that's what the clouds are. And so when you remove the clouds, all of a sudden the clouds start to break up. The sun is there shining. And that's the perfect analogy that I could give everybody who has any doubt, is there a God? And that's the perfect analogy. God is like the sunshine that's always shining, that's always bright on a cloudy day, and because he's always there.
That's beautiful.
And thank you. And so, you know, when you look, you know, if you really wanted to look deep, because people who say, I don't believe, you know, it, like I said, I've said this many, many times before in our show, you know, when you look at the perfection of the earth and the sun and the ocean and the plenty of food and the plenty of gas on a daily basis. And, you know, I was even looking at, I'm going really deep now, I'm looking at the train tracks, and to lay train tracks throughout the entire country where everything has to be perfect for this heavy machinery to fly like 60, 70, 80 miles an hour, where it can't even be off by an inch or two. It's got to be perfect. Right. And to lay it across the country, up and down, north, east, west, south, every which way, it's got to be perfect. Just like the planes, just like the ships. You know, I mean, it's just perfect. Even the mailing system, where you have 20,000 letters going to one post office, and it's going to go to 20,000 places within 1 or 2 days, is amazing. I mean, and the English language, you know, any language is amazing. And what happens if there was no time? Time was created, you know, and there's a reason why time was created. Can you imagine if time wasn't created? Everyone would be late, but we wouldn't even know what late is.
Right.
Like, hey, when's your husband coming? The word when wouldn't even exist.
That's right. That's right.
It's like, damn, I keep on waiting for this person.
I know. How about
I've waited three sundowns for you.
I'll tell you how the Indians, then how we do it. Listen to this. We go by winters. That's the way we count our age, by winters.
Really?
Yes. So wow. You're so many winters old.
Wow.
Yes. We go by the seasons.
I wonder how old Shelley Winter is.
And that's a winter I would like to know.
There's a winter. She's been a winter her whole life.
Well, you know, it's I've been alive, let's say, umpteen winters.
Yeah.
I think everybody knows how old I am, but I'm not going to remind myself to depress myself. No, it's let's say you're 25 winters old, and that's how we go about, you know.
I'm 25 winters and three snowballs.
He's 25 winters on the half one side, and the other side is another 25 winters.
25 winters in a summertime. That's funny. All right, we have somebody on the line.
I want to ask you a question.
Oh, wait, don't go on the line.
Wait a minute. Just wait,
Brian.
If my husband didn't come home from work and we had no time, how could I yell at him?
You can't. There would be no arguments about anything. Like, you know, right now we say timing is everything. It really is. Timing is everything. But, you know, seriously, God created everything for this earth. He created everything.
Everything.
The birds, your dogs that you love so much, your cats that you love so much, your birds that you love so much, your hamsters.
How could they not believe in God?
It's because of their anger, because they're so angry, because they lost their parent at an early life, or they were neglected, or they were abused, and it's like, how come no one's helping me? And like, there's so many reasons.
That's just so fitting. That's thanks.
It is, but when you're living in it, you know, from the get-go,
yeah.
I mean, and you don't have much love to bounce off of, and you're just dealing with aggression, you're just dealing with negativity, and it's just a non-stop. So if you had nobody else to experience love at any capacity, even for people who don't have friends or hardly any friends, or maybe their friends are negative. A lot of people have a few friends, but they're always negative, or they're negative.
Yeah.
You know, so there is, you know, that's dark. It's terrible, but it exists, and it's understandable why people think the way they do. So it's about having compassion and not so much as challenging them or debating them, you know. And, you know, you could, you know, I mean, I just explained in our belief system why we believe there is a God, you know.
Right.
It just, there's just too many things that have happened.
Too much proof.
Too much proof in this lifetime. And so, you know, for people who don't believe in God, you know, still say God bless you when they sneeze.
Right. Who does God say? What does Jesus say when God sneezes? What does Jesus say?
What do you mean?
God is Jesus's father in my religion. Okay.
God's everybody's father.
This is true.
God is everybody's
father. I understand
father.
That. So what is God, what is, let's say, Jesus or Saint Michael the Archangel? When God sneezes, what does he say?
When God sneezes?
Yeah.
God bless myself.
Yeah.
Bless me.
Bless me. Bless me.
I always say when at the end of some of the segments, I said, listen, God bless everyone and God bless yourself.
Right?
You know?
Yes, you do.
Life is filled with many blessings.
It is.
And like I said, everything is a perception. So it's as big as it is. It's as small as it is. It's as bad as it is. And it's as good as it is, according to the energy and the perception that you give anybody or anything.
And don't let anybody take away your love, joy, or happiness.
Right.
Yes. Well, we have a Sonia from Pennsylvania. Sonia, you still there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hi, sweetie. What's up? How you doing?
Hi. Great show so far. You guys are great performers, to say the least.
Thank you. That's very kind of
you.
Just come a little closer to your receiver so we could hear you.
I'm sorry. Okay, can you hear me now?
What, honey?
Can you hear me now better?
Yeah, yes. We're fine.
Now we're good.
America can hear you now.
Okay, thank you. I was calling because of a domestic situation I'm ongoing here. Somebody is due to move out of my house. Hopefully, well, they told me either the first or the second. And this has been a situation that have escalated and me having to call the police very recently, 2 weeks ago, and then last year. used to be involved. We're no longer. The house is in my name. Taking everything she ever gave me and stuff that she got in the house. I don't want anything. There's boxes, stuff packed all over. And I just want everything to go smoothly. I'm paying no mind to, you know, her. I'm trying to just keep my distance and isolate myself from her. Very minimal communication. What are you picking up from this?
You know, this might sound so crazy in what you said, but I'm picking up the energy of a little boy, a young boy. Not really baby, but a young boy, maybe 12, 9, 11, like that. Can you relate to that?
Well, not really. I don't have any brothers, and I just have sisters.
Okay, I feel that there's a young blonde boy that is somewhere in this mix. I really do. As crazy as that sounds, and it may not make sense to you right now, but you will find out later on that this is something about a blonde-haired boy. I don't know why.
I'm going to tell you what I'm getting. I want you to visualize positive outcomes as far as exactly what it is that you're hoping for. I don't want you to worry how it's possibly going to happen. I just want you to believe that the outcome is going to favor you. And this is exactly what the angels are saying to me right now.
Right.
And it's about keeping your faith and keeping your integrity. Keeping an open mind is extremely important. And try not to judge the process of what you're going through. But just know that the end result is going to put you in your possible best scenario. And the more you try to fight what does not belong to you or what is not in your highest best interest, because a lot of people fight to get what they say they want, and yet in their subconscious they know that it's not best for them, you know, and they're still fighting to have what they say they want. So learn to accept the things as they fall and just know that everything is going to turn out perfectly okay in the end. And that's exactly how I feel about your overall situation. I feel like things are really going to favor you, but you just need to trust and be open.
Sonia, do you have a place to go to?
No. This is my house. I'm the sole owner. She's staying there. I'm not the one moving out.
Okay. I wasn't able to hear the whole conversation.
No problem.
But I do feel, as Artie does, that in this case, you could manifest your own destiny. So if you keep repeating over and over again how you expect the outcome or how you want the outcome to be, it's going to happen. And I actually feel like angels in your favor, because I'm seeing angels like rooting in my mind. So I'm feeling that angels are on your side. Angels are in your favor. Call them out. And I want you to talk to them just like you're talking to us and tell them exactly what you want to happen. And it'll happen.
It's going to be a give and take situation. And just know what is worth fighting for and what's worth letting go.
Right.
But I'm just letting you know, just to be open. But right now we have to go for a break.
Good luck, Sonia.
Okay. Thank you.
All right, stick around, everybody, because Sky and I, we're going to be right back right after this commercial break.
Smelling sweet. Move up the road to the outside of town and the sound of that good gospel beat.
Tune in to the Angels and Answers Psychic Radio Show with clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegel every Thursday for a 2-hour show, 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio. Artie and Sky deliver spiritual and motivational messages with passion and a sense of humor. Call in 800-930-2819 for live and on-air readings. Visit ArtieHoffman.com and SkyOfAngels.com.
naturopathic doctor, founder of the Martha's Vineyard Holistic Retreat, and author of the New York Times bestseller, 21 Pounds in 21 Days, Dr. Ronnie DeLuce has helped tens of thousands of people, including celebrities and athletes, with her message of lifestyle change. Now Dr. Ronnie DeLuce wants to help you. You too can be saved. Email Dr. Ronnie DeLuce at info@ronniedeluceonradio.com and visit mvholisticretreat.com. Dr. Ronnie DeLuce, your partner in wellness.
Holistic Medical Center is where you find it all. A healthy space with doctors who care, see, and listen to the whole you. Hi, this is Dr. Darvish. If you have not found an answer to your chronic symptoms, you will find answers here at Holistic Medical Center. Our doctors find the root cause of your symptoms and guide your body towards healing naturally. We transform lives from within. Visit drdarvish.com or call 425-451-0404.
Each month, listen to Live More Radio with co-host Ali Katz. Join Ali and Dr. Pat as Ali introduces new ways to bring balance back to your life through meditation, sleep, and exercise techniques so you can live your truly authentic life. Stress less, live more. To learn more about Ali, visit ATOZENmeditation.com.
Artie Hoffman is the hottest psychic with the warmest heart and the host of the hit show Angels and Answers. A renowned psychic medium, spiritual life coach, and an entertaining motivational speaker, Artie has helped over 15,000 people with his amazing intuitive gifts, his passion, and his humor. Call 877-ANGEL-02 to schedule a personal reading or to have your own psychic Artie party. That's 877-ANGEL-02. And visit ArtieHoffman.com and Angels and Answers on Facebook.
We've already said
welcome back, everyone, to Angels and Answers with Sky Siegel and Artie Hoffman.
And Sky, if somebody would like an amazing reading with you.
Amazing?
Yeah, it's like amazing. You're like internationally known right now.
I know.
And you know, and Tony Stark, well, he backs you up.
Oh,
and
absolutely.
He knows that you're amazing. And so, you know, everybody would like to know your phone number so they could get the best mediumship reading ever.
All right, I'd be very happy.
And it's all right at your beck and call, all right? She doesn't have a 2-year waiting list. It's much shorter than that.
That's right.
And she will give you the best that best has to offer. So, Sky, go ahead.
Okay.
Go ahead.
908.
Go ahead.
500.
Keep going.
1474.
There you go. And that was beautiful. That was absolutely amazing. I paid attention to the whole thing. It was
What's
amazing.
What's my number, Artie?
It's 908.
I'm covering it, folks.
You know, you're a bitch sometimes.
Sometimes.
908-500-1474.
Very good.
That's
and
it. I paid
number?
Attention. And if anybody would like a...
Here comes
really.
Elvis. Elvis, attention to the building.
My number is 877-ANGEL-02. So if you would like a reading, a mediumship psychic, and if you want some comedy, I do know plenty of jokes. So... we're open Monday through Sundays, you know, double matinee on Saturdays. But please give me a call, 877-ANGEL-02, and I promise you it will be an amazing reading.
I'm all choked up.
And she's all choked up.
That's so funny.
Oh, wait, and my website is ArtieHoffman.com. Go ahead. Tell them your 1-900 number.
Talk about that anymore.
Yeah, those days.
For those special evening readings. My number
for those
is,
of you who have more money than most people for 1-900 numbers.
And are lonely.
Are you lonely tonight?
I told you Elvis entered the building. Hey.
You know, it was really funny.
Wait,
I saw a comic strip, and you know, it's like, and they did a role reversal in this comic strip, and you know, like, you know, when say like call girls in New York, and they hang around this the corners, say whether it be 42nd Street or
are
around
you
the tunnel.
Are prostitutes? Yeah. No, they're not call girls.
Yeah, whatever. They're the same difference.
No, they're not.
Same difference.
No. Call girl is when you call up and you order a date. A prostitute is somebody that walks the streets. She could be, a call girl could be a prostitute.
The bottom line is it's about sex.
Okay.
That's all I care about.
That's all he cares about.
That's the whole
Let's
premise.
Let's get our terminology correct.
All right.
Go ahead.
So here we are. So this, as she's getting her iced tea right through her nose, this is a beautiful thing.
She kills me.
Okay. So anyway, so the situation is that a girl, you know, will hang over into the window and talk to the guy and try to have a good time and stuff. So this comic strip has the girl as the driver and the guy is walking the streets and he leans over into the window and he says to the girl, "Hey, sweetheart, you want to have a good time tonight?" He goes, "I can listen to you talk all night long." You know, because
I didn't get it.
Because girls emotionally want to be satisfied and they like to talk. They like communicators. It's about emotions.
You're right.
It's not about the physical sex.
Right.
So this guy's leaning over like, you know, he's a John, and, you know, like not the John, but the call guy, you know, the prostitute as a male. And he said, "Hey, baby." He goes, "Come on, let's go into a room." He goes, "I'll listen to you talk all night long." You know.
And we'll go see a chick flick.
That's right. We'll
that
do whatever
so
you
cute.
Want to do.
That's so cute. So, does anybody, you have any plans for this weekend?
We have to go to a commercial break. Come on,
are you serious? No.
It seems like every 2 minutes is 15 minutes.
I was going to fall off my chair. We were just laughing about this during the commercial break. Yeah. It's like every time we turn around, there's another break.
It's like, yeah, hello, Sonia. I would love to talk to you, but we have a commercial break. Sorry we weren't able to tell you anything.
Right? I feel like
it goes by that fast.
Holy crap. That was crazy.
Yeah.
What was I going to tell you just a minute ago?
You're talking about prostitutes and call girls. No. You're talking about your 1-900 number and how you almost gave it up like cigarettes, but you can't.
Yeah, but I can't.
But you can't, so you went back to both.
I can't help myself. I can't help myself.
So I got to tell you this funny joke because we literally do only have a few minutes until we go to a break.
Word.
So there's this heavy set comedian. I told you this joke before, but this is funny.
Yes.
There's this heavy set comedian, this guy, and he says, you know, he's standing there and he goes, when I was younger, I used to be a very good looking guy. He goes, and I used to smoke in my younger days. He goes, but the only time I would have a cigarette was during, you know, right after sex. He goes, I haven't had a cigarette in a long time. He goes, I'm dying for a cigarette. He goes, my goal is to become a chain smoker.
You know, you never told me that one.
Get out of here.
No, you never did. That was a new one. That was very good.
Really?
Yes. I wouldn't mind.
Oh, wow.
You know me.
Wow.
Anyway, folks, we really want you to call in. We only have 3 more minutes before
another break. Yeah, we only have 2 minutes till we go to another break.
Oh, my God.
We spent the whole time talking about how we go through breaks like really
like
quick.
Crazy.
And now it's almost
now
time
it's almost
for
time
another
for break.
Holy but we still have, yeah, we still have, 3 minutes. We still got 3 minutes. We'll jibber jabber.
Okay, let's jibber.
All right. That sounds good.
You know, folks, we're really happy that you guys call us in because we like you to get involved in our situations, our talks, you know, our topics.
And when you call in, we're not just there to help you, but there's a lot of people who are listening in who's dealing with a lot of the same similar situations.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, some of you who are brave enough to call in, that's great. And our number is 800-930-2819, 800-930-2819, you know, and feel free to give us a call. And like I said, if you want to talk about a particular topic,
right.
If you're in deep poo-poo in your life, whether it be on behalf of yourself or your loved ones, you know, feel free. And, you know, Sky and I, we're not – I don't feel that we are opinionated type people.
No.
We literally, you know, sit in the moment and we get fed information in the moment,
yes,
to give you the answers you need to hear.
We don't rehearse. We don't think.
Right. There's no pre-prepping for
nothing.
The show. Everything happens in that moment.
It's like the spur of the moment.
It's like Jackie Gleason and the Honeymooners. There was no preparation. He never did rehearsals. He did everything spontaneously when the show happened.
Right.
That was amazing. That was absolutely amazing.
And the reason why we do that is because we don't know what Spirit is going to tell us until we hear your voice.
But the second part of our segment, which we should have started on the first one, but it went really well anyway, is about chasing after your dreams.
And we have 1 minute to a commercial. So, folks, please stay tuned.
And give us a call at 800-930-2819 if you wish to have a reading. If you don't want to and you want to just listen to us jibber-jabber, that's perfectly fine, too.
Or if you'd like to tell us some of your stories about how you met Spirit or Spirit has come to
you. Or your unusual circumstances, we're more than happy to hear it.
We love that.
All right, everybody. Well, listen, stick around because Sky and I, the dynamic duo that we are,
da-da-da,
we're going to be right back right after this commercial break.
You've been listening to Angels and Answers Psychic Radio Show with clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegel. Tune in every Thursday for this great two-hour show at 2 p.m. Pacific and 5 p.m. Eastern Time. And remember to call in at 800-930-2819 to get answers from your guardian angels and loved ones. Artie and Sky have helped thousands of people with remarkable accuracy as they tune in, use their intuitive gifts and inner guidance, and communicate with people's angels and loved ones who have passed on. To schedule your session, call Artie at 877-ANGEL-02 and visit ArtieHoffman.com and call Sky at 908-500-1474 and visit SkyOfAngels.com for personal or group readings. And tune in next week for this fabulous hit show.